can cook up. Me too, sweetie. This brush is not doing what I needed to do. Yep. Actually, trying to figure out how the chat works. Let's just do it on my tablet. I'm pretty sure they can. The mic is on. Figure out what to paint. Thank you. People are probably gonna trip out when they see me drinking this big ass water thing. Only way to stay hydrated. Doing all right over there, baby? That sounds like a blast. Oh my God, this music is terrible. Seriously. They won't let me play like Lupe Fiasco and stuff. It'll literally say it's copyright and we'll mute it. It's crazy. They have some sort of a tool to identify the music. And I figure it out because this royalty-free music stuff is terrible. And I've heard people listening to like, you know, copyrighted music or whatnot. That's what they have to do. That's it. Wow, okay, so then I need to learn how to do that so I can just play other music. I do not own. It's not mine.
I do not have.
Nothing to do with me. I didn't do it. I'm just listening to it. Promise. I'm gonna break down my door. Listen to the Final Fantasy VII. It's copyright. Somebody on Facebook asked me, what tool do I use? Like Photoshop? God, why do people still ask that? How do they not know? Like, if you're into digital art at all, how do you not know about Photoshop?
Maybe it looks so good, it looks
realistic. No. No way. Maybe. kind of looks like a bridge. A bridge between lava. Yeah, I think I found the concept in this one. Now all I gotta do is spruce it up. Where does the light go? It's always a tricky question. Yeah, I feel the higher up it goes, the duller it should get. And that's why I have to switch my brushes up. Saturation, right? That's what I messed up on. Classic strategy of flipping the canvas, get a new view on things. That helps clear up the composition. Thank you. Seems like everything is going smooth. Doing all right on that resume?
Maybe. We'll find out if I get it.
Sound so tired already. Is it sleepy time, baby? Good. Gonna stay up with me.
Maybe.
I see it in your future. I was just stretching. I was doing a weird yawny, stretchy, facey thing. What is that guy doing? What is wrong with him? That's highly unusual. I came up with a really cool composition. I just gotta get the values right. I think you'll like it when you see it. Something different. Change. Thank you. I should be talking about what I'm doing, baby. Give them the rundown. Oh wait, when someone gets in here. I've got it uploaded on my tablet, the chat. So when someone comes in and says something, I'll know. Or when someone comes in, I'll know. Mm-hmm. These first strings would be pretty lonely.
Forever alone
in darkness. Oh, my soul. Yeah, the very first thing I'm going to do is figure out how to stream with any type of music I want. Figure out where I need to put that and figure out all the guidelines. This jazz music is just putting me to sleep. Like 5 or 10 minutes, I want to listen to some Lupe or something. Get me pumped up, energetic.
Lupe,
yeah,
so
yep, I was listening to Jordan's
Wave.
Real
party music. Lupe, yes.
What? That's good music.
Yeah, it's
good party. Well, am I supposed to listen to the Migos?
Yeah.
So I need to listen to the Migos is what you're telling me. It's the only way to get hype. Right. You've heard it here, ladies and gentlemen. The only way to get hype is to listen to the Migos.
Party.
It's the only way to do
it.
Say
Migos, party.
You don't need party music. You can get hype off all types of stuff.
Get hype off jazz?
The right type of jazz. This is the sleepy type of jazz, not the energetic, like, type of jazz. You know the jazz I usually listen to. Way more energy than this. This is like some old dude with like really big eyes looking at you. He's like, yeah, boy.
With his little fedora on.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you a story. I knew this girl. Oh, shut up already. Old man, no one cares. Too tired. What you snickering about? Oh, of course. Some more darks. There you go. That was the problem. I didn't make that the foreground. Starting to come together. You still up over there, baby? That sounded like a whimper. Yeah, that's what gets you hyped for real. Ice cream. It's fine now.
Bacteria.
Ugh, it's salt. Definitely that. I said definitely that soup. That's super, super salty. Copyright thing, I think that only works for YouTube. And Facebook, oh, okay. Oh, so that's what you're talking about, it only works for Facebook? Oh, okay. Sorry, another streamer using what I thought was copyrighted. So how was he doing? It says it'll still mute it. So I'm looking up. time for an experiment. Hard work. Put in the hard time. It's finally starting to look like something. because I have most of the color palette established, but I need some more foreground background separation. That's why I'm adding these darker colors in the foreground, so everything else will appear a little bit further away. And sometimes you have to be really subtle with these areas. In the beginning of the painting, I went a little bit too contrasty, and that's why I had to go back in there. This looks a little bit more natural, but we've still got a ways to go. Take this canvas and flip it over. Still looks pretty messy, huh? Yeah, it does. Baby, what am I gonna do? I don't know if I can. Okay, baby. Stronger shapes. For instance, I can maybe make this a triangle. I just need to add another element to make it a bit more dynamic. So I can do some experimentation with shapes. kind of trying to sneak 3-point perspective in here somewhere. And I think these structures probably the best way to do it. So I'm really slowly trying to restructure these lines here to go to a vanishing point. Get that to read the way I want it to. I'm also trying to work with some curves or arabesque. That's the main composition of the piece. So if I can get that in a 3-point perspective, I think we got us a decent little sketch here. Thank you. like this jazz music, huh? Eggnog time. Eggnog time. You sure? Can you really resist? Sure. You're already thinking about it. What? Can you take a sip? You said what, baby? Aww. Ain't nothing wrong being an old lady. Man, streaming is tough, honey. Tough business here. Yeah. Hmm? Yeah. Painting for the crowd.
What crowd?
The one person that's here, honey.
Oh, there's one person there?
Yeah. There's one person. Yay.
Are you sure it's not yourself?
It is. It's the tablet. But hey, that's a loyal viewer. Man, I treat them all the same. Good job. I'm sure I'll grow after a while. At least this is a nice painting. Like, I can, this is a good stream here. It's a nice painting. I think it's one of my best.
Good for you.
I got that going. Do I get a pat on the back? How do I not get a pat on the back? It's kind of rude. Gonna play the world's smallest violin for me. Take pity on me, for I am a fool. ahead and go back to working on this S-curve. And messing with these shapes a little bit more. Trying to make this little rock here a little bit more interesting. Maybe add a bit more perspective. I think that could help. Tired, baby. Trying to bring this a little bit closer, so I'm using darker values. Even bring this in a little bit more as well. And now we can really start to get these effects. Be very careful. Ugh. Now we can add even more intense light. Maybe I usually don't use color dodge, but for this case I'm gonna try to sprinkle a little bit in. It's really easy to overdo it, so I'm trying to. Yeah, see, that already looks crazy. Also, I might have to do it the layering. I'm gonna sprinkle it here. Tab it not. I think that might be it. Okay. Okay, and let's get a little bit more light here too. After we add this texture, I'm gonna go back in and add more detail. But for now, I want to really add texture to the piece, so I'm just kind of sprinkling this brush in random places. You can pretty much get away with this, as long as you don't go too crazy. Okay. I'm actually gonna go through and add one more texture brush and see what I can come up with. Maybe old wood? If you ask me where I got these brushes, I have no clue. But I can recommend good places to look for brushes for anyone who needs texture brushes. Obviously, they don't make the painting. You have to know how to use them, but regardless, they're still very helpful when you want to get that painterly effect. I think that's what's lacking in most digital art is the texture. A lot of people don't have texture in their work, and it makes it look kind of dead. So, with those juicy textures in there to really bring life to the image. That's what I'm trying to do now. Big marks, small marks. Darker values because I'm kind of going over some of my previous values. That's completely fine, just part of the process. And this is anyone can use this technique. See, a lot of painters do it. I'm just biting. Biting all the techniques. Pretty undefined. Oops, I didn't mean to rotate. Come on. That always happens every time. Alrighty. I'm just gonna leave that undefined, actually. And add more textures on this area. And I definitely have to go in here and detail it. I don't know if I have enough time. Maybe, we'll see. More texture might be a little ambitious. I'm really just trying to add as many just imperfections, scratchy marks as I can. Just really go bananas with some of the color here. And maybe, do something like that. Add blue. Just add random stuff and see how it turns out. I do have to go back in and fix some of this, but it's not looking too bad. Alright, definitely gotta add some of these scratching marks. I mean, let's see. Yeah, let's do that. In the opposite direction, maybe. Something like that. And this is all pretty rough, and that's by design. I'm not trying to spend too long on it, but I'm also trying to experiment, use different colors and stuff that I normally wouldn't. Trying to get out of a habit of painting certain things. You can move over to this chalk brush. And I want to keep some of this texture, but I'll minimalize it. Yeah, there we go. Oops, cycle layers. And let's add that dark back in there. I'm still trying to sell that 3-point. I kind of forgot about it. We'll work it back in there. I really think I can do something special with this foreground element here. I really do. I don't know what, but I just feel like I could do something cool with it. Maybe add some contrast or something, like a different color light source. I don't think that looks right, but I'm gonna go with it anyway. Because at first it had this really cool blue in the background, something like that. I really like that. But again, it might be over ambitious. But sometimes you just gotta try. Really, all of this is just, I don't know. This is starting to bother me now. I feel like something else should be here. I really do. Gotta make another big change. Super late in the piece. That'll help sell the 3-point. Okay, I feel a little bit more comfortable about this. Panicking for a second. Came all this way just to mess up something. But I think we saved that. Still not 100% about it though. Something about it looks weird. What do I do in this situation? I am completely at a loss. Maybe I need to take a little hand break. Let's flip it. Hmm. Looking good, looking good. Yeah, man, I got another 15 minutes in me. And then I think I might have to call it quits. I really want to stream a little bit longer. Maybe I'll just take a break. Try to push out one more piece. That's what a real streamer does. He doesn't give in to his tiredness and his inability to get through the struggle. He just gets through the struggle. Full octane energy. I can feel it surging now. My second wind is coming. Or maybe not. I don't know. This a little bit cleaner, about like that maybe, and then we can, there we go, I like that, and can find the value in between, yeah, something like that maybe, that looks cool, can add that in there. Need some warmness to it, because I mean it's right by the lava. This is what this is missing. I'm gonna go ahead and add in some of that strong saturation. Then I'm gonna work on the lava a little bit more. So I can pump this up. Trying to figure out how to light this rock. Okay. Maybe it just kind of just tunnels through here. And this will get darker as well. Really saturated too. Yeah, like that. Add a bit more effect. A bit more effect. Effect though, I guess lava, light. That's what I'm really going for. Again, going back into these shapes. And now let's add a little bit more to the lava. Maybe a little orange, I don't know. Lava is usually like two colors. I don't know those two colors. I probably should do some research on that. But I feel like it's kind of like maybe this. perhaps. Okay. I still feel some type of way about that rock, but whatever. I feel like I need another dark value right about here. Really darken that up, actually. There we go. Maybe a bit too much. Some of this. Okay. Just trying to define this a little bit more. These lower regions. Clean up shapes. Yeah, I mean, I think this is coming together, you know? Worth the time and effort. Put in some work. Lava futuristic something or other. I actually want this to fade off quite a bit. This is the secondary color, so I'm gonna try to blend them a little bit. Blend it right there and right here. Yeah, just like that. Maybe. I also need to add more visual information, which basically just means smaller marks. That's what's keeping this from really looking the way I want it to. Again, I'm trying to put in some more time. Getting a little tired. Might need a Red Bull. Kick some energy into me. Oh God, if I start memorizing royalty music, that's gonna be terrible. I totally know this tune, Jesus. I need to make this shape a little bit. It's more separate, something like that. That is cute going back. Maybe make it smaller? I'm not sure what to do. I feel like this should be a bit darker. And this should go back. that perspective right. That's tough. I'm not the best at perspective at all, so. See, I take my time. This edge a bit harder so it stands out. You remember, this is super close, so I need to add those intense darks. Good old detailing, most brain dead part of the painting, just basically adding little in-between values, making things clear. And I had that texture and I'm kind of painting over the texture a bit, but that's fine. I can always add it back in. Going to sleep, baby?
Yeah.
All right, good night. You can turn it off. Oops. Try this one. this actually might be worse. Maybe make that a little bit brighter. Add a little bit of highlights to these rocks. Just a little bit. So easy to overdo it. We gotta figure out how to do the bottom of the lava. meditating, I didn't even know. Does the job. Also, I feel like this should be really bright as it gets to this area here. There we go. Just brighten up stuff, really. Maybe this could be like a little area in between. Kind of where you had to start using your imagination a bit. Still is very messy, but I'm not planning for this to be a big sketch. But I will clean it up a little bit. Color picking some of these values around here to speed up the process a little bit. I'm gonna try to get to a decent level in the next 20 minutes. Or maybe I'll just take a break. We'll see. We'll see about it, guys. I do like the piece, though. I haven't done anything like this before. It feels very treacherous. Treacherous in these areas. In the foreground, and I might capitalize on that by adding some little people or something there. That'd be pretty cool. Like they're traversing this cave to get to this crazy ruin, some ancient city or something that's just sitting here. And I might even go through and make this building or whatever structure look more like ruins. Going back in and making sure that structure still. I'm gonna add another one in there right here to really show that perspective, the 3-point. Okay. Starting to come together. I don't even know how long I've been working on this one. It's been a while. The life of a concept artist. Draw, 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 paint, paint, paint. Don't breathe. Don't do nothing else. Just do your art. Live free and let your soul burn with passion. I don't even know what this is, honestly. I just said it was going to be like ruins or something. Maybe I should start making it look a little bit more dingy. Like, I'm just adding marks. And just hoping something kind of comes together. Might go back in and add a little bit more texture in some areas. Probably not here. There's plenty of texture here. If anything, I might add some more in this area. Well, more light, not texture. Start defining some of the lava flow and some of these rocks. It's actually a pretty cool shape. A little sharp shape. I like that. And add more of that. Maybe even some sort of bridge or a secondary fortress. Just a tiny bit light right here. Just a little bit. I'm not gonna even go overboard with it. Just a little light. Shine a little light. And the flames. And spark the rebellion. Don't even get me started on The Last Jedi. Ugh. I'll just hold my opinion. Wouldn't want to cause any controversy. Bit more to these shapes here, kind of barren. Okay, just to taking my time. These shapes over here that are so dark definitely don't need to be there. And we can pull out another brush, go to work. Start pulling some of this stuff in, calling it quits. Yeah, I've said that multiple times. Happens a lot when you paint, think you're done. And you just want to go through one more time. Then you want to go through one more time. Next thing you know, it's been a whole another 2 hours. So, just go in here. Add that texture. Maybe switch the colors a little bit. You know, sometimes you have to do that. Thank you. brush. I really want a nice, flowy texture. And that's not it. Might be one of the rare times I actually rotate the canvas just so I can get this one stroke. Something like that. Maybe not as hard. I just need to be a bit more simple. Alright, let's see. I think that works. I'm still not happy with this dark. I think it needs to be more saturated, maybe a different hue. I'm gonna try that and see what happens. Perhaps. Just not clear yet. The path remains clouded. Let's just go somewhere else, try some, add some darks here. There. I'm still not sure about this part. If all else fails, use the texture brush and go somewhere else. What's going on over here? Thought I forgot about you, didn't you? Bam, bam, bam. Honestly, there's one part of this painting that I don't like, and it's this foreground element. I don't like this. This doesn't feel right. I have no clue how to fix it either. I really don't know what to do. I'm lost. Someone, please come assist me. Cause I like keeping that flow and that shape, but it's. Interesting. Yeah, and that feels even weirder. More weird. Okay, so add some more darks. Part of the plan. Okay, gotta edit that dark. I'm gonna try to figure out what the heck to do with this shape. Foreground, that's too warm. I need a cool color. Maybe something like that. I just want a little bit darker in some of these areas. Adding some more flow in there. Even though it's pretty abstract, I think the brush strokes come through just enough to get that S curve that I've been trying to go for. Let's flip it, flip it. Slow ass computer, not flipping. Or did it just flip and I didn't? Oh wow, see, that's how sleepy I am. I literally missed the flip. Getting sloppy, kiddo. I'm gonna have to replace you. Do your job, or else you're out of here. Let's add some more. Because I had this dark shape, so I need to do something with it. You know, when you have this type of atmosphere, you want things to kind of be blurry, and then at the focal point be a little bit sharper. So that's why I'm not going in as hard as I probably could. How that looks. Pretty good. Not bad. And don't want to detail too much stuff that's in the shadows. Want to really stick to where I was. Dang, Navit. Come on. Okay, there we go. That rotate tool is giving me trouble all the time. I don't know why. I think it might be too fast or something. Because it should not be that difficult to get it to rotate back. See how much I just struggle with that? Pathetic. You call yourself an artist. You haven't mastered the tools. You've merely gotten by. Ain't no smaller shapes in there. That's what I was talking about earlier. Yeah. These paintings take forever, they really do. But I'm having fun. Glad to be doing art. these trees with the tree brush. See what I can get cracking. Alright. Work for me, tree brush. Work for me. You're my one and only. You know I need you. I don't know what that was, don't ask me. I'm just trying to do some trees, man. Painting a live stream, 12 in the morning. Trying to do work, trying to do Lord's work out here. Work with me, tree brush. Get some Bob Ross trees in there. They'll love it. Some over here. Okay. I'm digging it. You know, nature is important. Save the rebellion. Save the trees. That's what Forrest Whitaker has been, the same actor in those movies for so long. My love for us would have Ghost Dog, Last King of Scotland. Yeah. I think that looks cool, so I need more elements, but I'm too lazy to add them right now. I'm wrapping this up. Gotta wrap it up. Careful about what I add now. Probably needs to be a little bit thinner. Even thinner. Even thinner. Come on, brush. Even thinner. There we go. Just add that right there. Probably why I'm yawning so much. I do this for y'all. All zero people that are here. I do this for all of y'all. The grind. The daily grind. Maybe some different colors. I think that'll help the piece breathe a little bit. Let's just be a little bit more. Let's see what we can just add here. Thank you. think that's a pretty interesting color to just throw in there, because you gotta think this is, I was gonna make it ruins, but forget it, I'll just go with a cool sci-fi design, because making it ruins at this point after adding all of this, I would just be deleting more information. And like I said, I'm gonna wrap this up soon to add some interesting color schemes here. I feel about this area. This should be simple. Maybe something like that. I'll make it brighter too. And there we go. I like that. And then I can add this little cool little V shape. There we go. Okay. Don't get too happy yet. Got way more stuff. I gotta add in the piece to make it ring true. I'm gonna try that. That adds a bit of dimension. Gotta keep it going though. I swear I want to put a stick man in there. I'm not even joking with you. I really want to put a stick man in there. That'll complete it. I've been saying I want to finish it, and you put that stick man in there. it's a wrap. It's done. Put the stick man in there. The stick man reigns supreme. Stick man forever. I put him in there. I'm done. I'm not touching this painting ever again. Sexy shape. Oh yeah. Ooh la la, mamma mia, pizzeria. I went from French to Italian. I'm tired. Let's put some brighter. Cause this is kind of facing upward, so that makes sense for it to be a little bit brighter. And while I'm at it, I might as well, let me desaturate it just a bit. Yeah. Some darks. Oh my goodness, that makes the shape look really weird. So now the question is, can I fix that, or does it need to even be fixed? I don't know, that comes off weird to me, honestly. I'm gonna have to cut this shape back. Got a dilemma. What do I do, George? What do I do? All this mess. Look at all this. This isn't even really a painting. It's just a bunch of marks. There's nothing here. Let's add another color. that's pretty much the same color. Let's try blue. Ooh, that's teal, and that's way too strong. I don't care. Just gonna add it. That actually looks cool. You know what? I think there's an area that I can add blue. Maybe right in this area. It could be like one of those dome things. I can make it white and then take the color back. Right here. Let's try from there to there and then put that down. I didn't forget about you, foreground. I can go through here and add a couple of shapes real quick, nifty. Get swifty. Shoot, I'm still confused about the perspective, because this could be like another, actually it really kind of is. So I need to add some shapes in here to show that. Because this is still kind of a lava fall. I'm sleeping, you know what I'm saying, it's going down, so I really need to show that perspective. The perspective ain't there right now. Ugh. Gotta go through and change it, man. Hey, strive for perfection. Now we can just do that and it gets darker and more saturated. Kind of apprehensive about that. Kind of make that a dome shape opening, so it's obvious. That looks terrible. Shape dynamic to make this work, because I can do this another way, but it's gonna take too much time. I want to do this the fast way once I get this damn eyelash out of my eye. Oh wow, it's three of them. Terrible. Worst feeling ever. Alright, back to business. Stay focused. Stay on track. else can I add? Not that that fits pretty nice, but can always add more elements to these type of, besides the stick man, of course. Shoot, I'm calling it quits. One more shape, one more. Then I'm off this stuff for good. Come on, there you go. Oh. I can't really touch my keyboard. I still gotta work on my setup. So this painting will be called Jajakajakajakayoi. Bam, did it. Got a decent painting in. Calling it quits. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen.